We will discuss three questions: why, what, and how. Why do we need to move beyond Ruby on Rails? Why do we need to extend our knowledge scope? It's all about complexity. If we talk about PayPal, it's all about security complexity. If we talk about Facebook, it's about scalability complexity. And extending your knowledge, you can gain many benefits. You can troubleshoot hard issue, you can scale, you can perform, and so on. So what should I learn to gain all these benefits? First of all, I suggest you to learn system programming. It's C, it's Unix API. You can increase your performance, you can build some fast C libraries, and I debugged many hard to debug issues via via knowing C language. Administration. Usually we scare to administrate something. We trying to avoid any administration work, but you miss a big piece of experience, because when you don't know administration, you don't know ability of your tools, you don't know all possibilities which you can gain from administrating your stuff. So don't hesitate, start from tools you use from day to day, Haproxy and Jinx, and master it, and step by step you can get better in this area. Today, everything is connected through the network. Every piece of your application works through the network. So to debug, to troubleshoot, you should take care of knowing network, and I suggest you to start from TCP learning, and in combination with Wireshark, you can get immediate knowledge how everything works under the hood. Concurrent programming. If you want to achieve better performance, or if you want to do some simultaneous task, you should understand how everything works. It's about shared memory, it's about mute access. If you want, for example, if you want to use JRuby, you should understand at which points you can fail if you use threading. Database is the main bottleneck when you scale something. So you should take deeper look at the current state of database. You should understand what is replications, which additional options give you your database, not only what you see in Rails, but it's also about some specific features like partial indexes, window functions in Postgres. And I suggest you to try Postgres if you don't try it before. Cryptography. Currently, it's high rise of popularity in cryptography. We know Bitcoin, but also we use cryptography from day to day in our Ruby sessions. If we integrate with some outer service, it's usually through the using of some cryptography. And I have an experience when I integrate with one site. Other sites suggest me to implement some algorithm, and I found that it was just insecure, and anybody can crack him. So we replace the scheme, but if I didn't dig in cryptography, we will have security hole. Algorithm, it's more advanced feature. It's not for beginning programmers, but when you mature, when you go to big performance, big load, you can benefit knowing algorithm, because you can get better algorithm and better performance. Try different external services. If you didn't touch any cloud service, give it a try. I do suggest New Relic. It's a must tool for every Rails project, because it can help you in debugging in several minutes you can debug any hard issue. But we shouldn't forget about Ruby. When you think you know Ruby, it's wrong, because Ruby is much deeper than you think. You can dive it and dig in it. You can ask what is under the hood and get a much better understanding of how everything is working. When you start using some programming language, you are in cage. This language gives you some approach. It shapes your mind, and you can't even don't understand that you are on the some path. And you can choose different language, and you will see how your mindset will change, and you can gain great benefit from programming in another language. For example, when I use Erlang, I back to Ruby, and my Ruby gets much better. You can get any of this language, and you will grow as programming, as programmer, and as Ruby programmer. The last question is, how can I learn all this stuff? And when you move into new knowledge area, you will be in the first trap. It's your fear. You will be scared. You will think, I can't get on this. I can't learn this stuff. And that's why not so many people don't know what is programming or what is system administration. But fear, it's can be passed quite easily. You should get pieces of your puzzle and gather basic understanding. I mean, when you see the first whole picture, when you understand the core, you will be enlightened and your fear will disappear. But now you go into second trap, and yeah, and this trap is clarity. You think, fuck, I know everything, but you don't. You just get some core puzzle. You just get a sketch, but you should zoom in and dive into details and get real experience, and then you can know many, but not everything. There is a common delusion that information is knowledge. In school and university, we get this as granted, and we think we read book and we know some language, but it's not true. You should fill your information with experience, and then you can get real knowledge. Don't take anything as granted, because people say you some unchecked information, and you can base your decision on this unchecked and unverified information. When you read some book or blog, try it in your real environment, check whether it is true. When you learn something new, you hit many little terms which stop you, and you think, fuck, I don't know anything. I should get through all these obstacles. But in reality, you just should lay them out and understand the meaning of every term, and then everything will be clear. When you start learning something new, choose some simple introduction articles, because RFCs is not the best way to start. You can learn by indifference. If you know Ruby, you know Python, you know PHP. Not for the whole, but a part of every this language. And if you find some man who can explain the difference between language, you will learn much faster. When you do some new work, you always have some silent questions, and you should take them some attention and lay them out and find the answer, and then you can move future. When you learning something new, you can find new topics. For example, I worked together with one system administrator, and he typed many bash commands, and I always asked him what he did, and I have many interested insights from him just by asking him what the fuck. There is blind spots when you use some usual things. For example, you can run top and see that not all items understandable by you. There are many numbers, but we approach it to these tools. We are accustomed to these tools, and we just ignore place that we don't understand. And you can take a fresh look and find these holes, and you can fill them with your new experience. You can ask when I will learn all this stuff, but everything is connected. If you learn one language, you learn many languages. If you learn networking, you learn scaling. Because when you move to scaling, many algorithms, many approaches already implemented in DNS, in TCP, and so on. Be in sync with your community. Many things change it every second, and you can benefit from new approaches, from new things in community. So read actual information. Note everything, because you can easily forget about things you have find an answer. So don't skip anything, and use the best tool for you to note new items. And the last thing I want to say is measure your progress only with yesterday you. You can't compare yourself with Unix guru or Ruby guru. You should ask the question, am I better today than yesterday? And if the answer is yes, you are growing. That's all. Thank you.